I was younger, my family would often take me to art museums. These museums varied in their geographic location, their significance, the stories they wanted to tell, but I remember one specific piece that had captured my interest. There appeared to be a visible incompleteness to it. It stood out amongst the rest of the paintings with its rougher outlines and its prevalence of white space. Museums, especially the more prominent institutes with a focus on the fine arts, tend to bring with them a sense of finality, completeness, a grandeur that's only expressed usually with the intention of being admired and gazed upon. But with each artist's rich history, I began to wonder where some of their unfinished pieces would go. Some would be displayed with the intention of preserving history, but what about the others? Stored in the back of museums, left in a forgotten corner of the artist's home, or even abandoned somewhere without anyone's knowledge. At times, I feel that an artist's unfinished work could be even more revealing about them as creators than some of their more admired pieces. It reveals to us their passions, motivations, the circumstances under which they created, allowing us a glimpse of time trapped on a half-finished canvas. Looking at unfinished art is a somewhat jarring process. There are big blotches of empty space and lines that seem to lead nowhere, coarse and disorderly edges that implicate instead of express. They stand as evidence of reflection, hesitation, in stark contrast to those seemingly perfect, swooping landscapes with dreamy colors and intricate portraits with appealing eyes displayed neatly on a museum wall. Part of what makes it so fascinating is probably because, in a way, unfinished pieces will never be finished. Recreations can come as close as humanly possible, but they'll never capture the essence of what the original artist might have intended. What's intriguing is the potential, what those colors could have looked like if the outlines were filled in. As I did some more research, I realized that the fascination with unfinished artwork was a somewhat widespread thing. In fact, there was a Met exhibition back in the year 2016 spanning the months March to September, which actually displayed unfinished artwork. They were split into two groups, one being actually unfinished, dropped by the artist for one reason or the other, while the other group was intentionally left in an unresolved manner. This exhibition, along with the numerous other articles and experiences online, demonstrate a unique experience. We are so fascinated by this concept of unfinishedness, even if it embodies something that we are naturally averse to, incompletion. In a way, it reminds me of my own unfinished projects, which always leave me feeling a little bitter. There's a sense of disappointment, which I've grown to question. Is this sense of failure and dissatisfaction justified when I look back at what an assignment could have been? In the case of personal artwork, in my pursuit of completion, I was no longer creating something to express myself or to convey an idea. I was continuing it purely for the sake of completing it. They weren't pieces of art to me anymore, but rather some sort of vehicle that carried with them feelings of accomplishment and success. This sort of conflict is what prompted me to start thinking about the nature of not completing things. Is completion necessary for feelings of achievement? Does failing to complete something automatically bar me from feeling satisfied and accomplished in the process, convey to me that I failed at a task? Does a project retain its quality when being produced under conditions of pressure? Could, in some ways, things be even better in their unfinished state? During the Renaissance, the sculpting technique known as non finito was pioneered by Donatello. Sculptors who utilized this technique carved figures that looked as if they were materializing, emerging out of slabs of pure marble. This technique was rooted in philosophical origins, highlighting the idea that there was indeed some sort of value within emptiness and seeming unfinished. On the other hand, a historical Chinese technique used in the fine arts is known as liu bai, literally leaving white. It's where an artist intentionally left emptiness in their works to leave room for interpretation, imagination, or simply to convey stillness and serenity. The concept of incompletion grows infinitely larger. The human fascination towards completion is also demonstrated in Gödel's incompleteness theorem, a theorem that pretty much broke the mathematics world when it was first proposed in 1931. Kurt Friedrich Gödel was a German-Austrian mathematician considered to be one of the most significant logicians of the 20th century. There were two axioms of mathematical logic that highlight the difficulty in creating a complete and consistent mathematical theorem. Since all mathematical statements must be proven, being a field rooted in logic and quantifiable concepts, Gödel's theories had far-reaching and severe implications. His first theorem basically states that any system using basic arithmetics is either incomplete, meaning some statements can't be proven, or inconsistent, meaning it lacks contradiction. Gödel argues that it's impossible to prove the completeness of a theorem, as it's impossible to prove every single formula, for example, a system creates, to be true or false. Furthermore, if something has to be proven true, its opposite must be proven false. His second theorem established that a consistent system cannot prove its own consistency. Generally, he proved that there was no absolute way to prove any mathematical theorem. Gödel's theories of incompleteness are so confusing and near unnerving because of how it undermines human confidence. It calls into question the seemingly factual and unshakable faith we've had in systems and our own ability to uncover the unknown. It's unsettling because of how difficult it is to grasp. It tests the limits to our knowledge. Even something as deep-rooted as mathematics itself, seeming so inherent in our natural world, cannot be definitively complete. And if we want to get even larger with the concept of completeness, Sartre, a philosopher and one of the pioneers of existentialism, highlighted the incompleteness of human nature itself. Sartre proposed that man comes from nothingness and creates his own reality, but to what end? When is man complete? Because in some ways, we hold the paintbrushes to the canvases that are our own lives. In certain cases, this is reflected in people who generally feel dissatisfied with their lives, that there's something missing in their perpetual chase for completion. Incompleteness is everywhere. It's not something to view as a failure or something that always needs to be avoided. How can we view incompleteness as something so unacceptable when it's so integral to the learning process and experience as a whole? Incompleteness should be embraced. Just because there's inherent incompleteness in how we exist in the first place, according to Sartre, it doesn't mean we're going to give up on existing. The incompleteness within us is what allows us to seek more and be more active, motivated in our pursuits. Just because Gödel's theorem proved that no consistent, complete mathematical system can exist, it doesn't mean we've abandoned mathematics as a whole. In fact, it's helped develop the field of mathematics in terms of innovation and education. Just because a piece of artwork is left unfinished, it doesn't mean it can't have value or achievement in its creation, in its history. Intentional emptiness, like non finito or generally unfinished artworks, are both a part of practicing techniques and can reveal important features about the artist. But obviously, on a grander scale, works are meant to be completed and jobs are meant to be finished. I'm not encouraging anyone to write half of an essay and pontificate to their teachers about the nature of incompleteness or complete only half of their house chores. But in the continual expanding experience of life, incompleteness will be an inherent part of learning and other experiences as a whole. Trying to actively act against the inherent incompleteness that we face in every learning process and experience, we may actually reduce our enjoyment, our motivation, and the things we get out of doing the things that we do. If you do art for the sake of completing it, eventually completion becomes the only driving force behind creativity. Coming to terms with completeness helps with personal growth. Coming to terms with the idea of incompleteness and its inevitability in everything we do allows us to recognize that at many times, incompleteness doesn't mean failure, and chasing after completeness is just the result of quick bursts of satisfying brain chemicals. Moreover, it helps us avoid the negative effects of perfectionism that often decrease motivation and productivity, even mental health as a whole. Our awareness of incompletion and both our perpetual chase for completion, along with our actions in spite of it, is what makes us so decidedly human.